What is going on, guys? Movie Sting here, back with a brand new video, and today you can see in the background it is some Forza Horizon 2 gameplay. On the Xbox One, I got FIFA 15, The Evil Within, Forza Horizon 2, and Worms Battleground so far on Xbox One. And here I'm just going to be showing off some Forza Horizon 2 gameplay in the BMW, and you guys can also help me out by liking, sharing, or commenting on this video, and be sure to look in the description for a survey, which will help me to decide what surveys and what changes need to be made for 2015 on this channel. But anyway, then let's get into this gameplay. Then it is a live commentary, so wish me all the best, and hopefully I can do well. Been pretty good so far in Forza Horizon 2. I really do like the game. Spent probably about 3 hours, got quite far on this game. It's certainly an extremely fun game. So many cars, so many varied locations. You've got like seafronts, inner city towns, you've got, you know, roaming across the country. The environments look absolutely amazing. There's the dynamic weather system, there's the day to night transitions. This is really an amazing game, and I definitely want to be doing a review on this. And I can tell you now, I would definitely recommend this game. It's, you know, got to be one of the best games on Xbox One. Certainly, in my opinion, probably looking likely to be the best exclusive anyway, especially if you're a racing fan. It's, you know, a must have if you do get an Xbox One. Unless you're completely simulation, then, you know, probably this isn't the game for you. I suppose it's quite arcadey. It's not that realistic. Although, you know, there is, you know, a good hint of realism, and with a wide variety of cars, and they all handle very differently. So, there's basically something for everyone. You know, there's track toys, saloon cars, muscle cars, sports cars. Of course, I'm driving a BMW now. I also have a Ferrari, some couple of track toys, the a Caterham and a Lotus, I believe. So, wide range of cars, wide range of locations. Definitely a brilliant game, and you can see it's definitely at times quite challenging. You can see there we're just about to maybe lose our podium slot, and we just managed to hold it. There's a wide variety of championships, a wide variety of, you know, varied races. You know, there's so many championships to do. I can't remember the exact figure, but you know, there is, I think, over a, you know, certainly over 100-200 races you can actually do towards various championships. I know you have to win 15 championships to get to the Horizon finale, and I think even after you finish the Horizon finale, there's so many championships still to do. You've got speed cameras, speed traps, and you've got this bucket list, barn finds. There's just so many things they've added in. They're basically taking everything good about Forza Horizon and made it great, and then, you know, they've taken everything that was lacking in the first Forza Horizon, and, you know, they've added it, and they've just put so much content in. This is, you know, hours. I'll probably never even complete it. I doubt anyone will really, you know, complete it to 100%, unless, you know, you were playing this for a couple of years, probably, because it is, you know, an amazing game. You can finish the career mode, but, you know, you probably can't finish all the kind of speed traps, find every road. There's something for everything, and one of my favourite things about this game is how it compares to your friends. Of course, you can see up ahead that Sabi Paradise 123, a former Afro League driver. You guys may not know, but anyway, he's basically on my friends list. But he is appearing then in this race as we come across the line to take second. That was obviously a sprint race, one of the shorter races. You can see there's also varied length. Basically, this kind of driver tiles, it's not actually them driving, it's just basically an AI car with their name. It's really cool. I do like the system. You know, it makes the AI drivers very aggressive, very realistic. Much more realistic than, say, you know, in a game like F1 2014, where the AI cars are just, you know, plainly AI cars. And otherwise, they'd just be given fake names. There won't be much meaning to it, but they really go the extra mile by adding these names in. And say you go through a speed trap, it'll come up with a leaderboard with your friends, and, you know, how do you compare? Who's gone the fastest? You can have competitions between you. I haven't been on the online, so I can't comment on that. But it does look really good from videos I've seen of it, and I'm really looking forward to doing it. You can see their favourite radio station. There are also different radio stations. You unlock more as you unlock new areas. You have these road trips. You kind of have a story to it, but it's not a story that kind of, you know, is very good. I mean, very complex. You know, it's a good story, but it's not really, you know, much more is really needed, to be honest. All you want to do is race, just kind of a short story. You kind of just have these kind of shortcut scenes that really get you, you know, pumped up for the next race, pumped up for the next location, pumped up for the next road trip. You can see I'll just show a bit of off-roading here. You can just go through all the fields, through the crops. It's just a lot of fun, through the trees. Just mind out for the poles, mind out for the larger trees. You just got to know what you can hit and what not to hit. Let's go through the forest and up to our next event. We'll just do that race and we'll end that video right there. We are in HD, in full 1080p. Obviously, we crash there a bit. It's very easy to do, especially when you're off-roading. But I think I've got pretty good at this game. You can see from the first race, That was pretty good. I think second is pretty respectable. We were level on points, I think, with AB Paradise. So hopefully in this third, after four races, we can hopefully win that race and win the championship. As you go on, the more championships you do, I think there's more races in each of the later championships. I started out as three, and now I've moved on to four races per championship. So I presume it might even move on to maybe five or even six. Here we are then at the festival. You can see that top right, there's all these skill points. You can basically earn points from drifting, near misses, and these all add up to skill points and perks, which basically allow you to get more XP, which allows you to level up more, which allows you to get high level, which allows you to get more wheel spins, which basically allows you to get more coins or more cars, and those coins can be put toward buying more cars and racing with more cars, earning more XP, more skill points, and so on and so forth. It all just leads up together to make, you know, an amazing game, just a lot of fun. I thought it'd get repetitive quite quickly, maybe a bit like apparently Forza 5 does. Of course I can't, you know, say that now because I haven't played the game. And a lot of people saying it's very repetitive, but I think Forza Horizon 2, you know, certainly isn't like Forza 5. It's certainly a lot less repetitive. It's new, fresh. The more you play it and the more your friends play it, of course, the better the game will get, because, you know, more people, bigger leaderboards, bigger targets to get. I'm sure, you know, you can kind of do these online road trips. I'm definitely looking forward to doing that. And, yeah, it's just overall a lot of fun to play. You can see that we've gone horribly wide at the first corner there. It's so easy to do that, but, you can see maybe a few familiar faces. I'm sure a few guys of you guys will know Silent Mole. That's actually Luke Julian. Anyway, we've bashed our way into fifth, and that's the thing I like. It's just pure racing. You know, there's no rules, no penalties. It's just, you know, free for all. You can shortcut if you really want to. You know, you can drive across off-road, and dynamic weather system, of course, you can see. I think that's only exclusive to Xbox One. It's either that, or I think it's, no, it's actually the day-night transitions. So we've actually pushed us and one of the, is it Silent Mole, through into second and third. You can just be as aggressive or as clean as you really want to. I'm just kind of having a bit of fun in this race after maybe a marginally clean race, and you can see there. It's quite good because you've got like AB Paradise, I suppose he's like the equivalent of a Mercedes F1, you know, you kind of got these dominant people, these slower guys, these faster guys. It's really good to see, and having a bit of a battle there, we kind of had nowhere else to go into the back of him, but you can see the top left. I like the percentage bar as well in these sprint races. You know how long you've got to go. They're really quick, kind of like 3-minute races, or you've got kind of the longer circuit races, which, you know, usually 3 or 4 laps of the same circuit. You know, you can learn it, perfect your braking points, and there's a wide, you know, variety of assists catering for everybody. And you can turn these off to get more XP, which is always good. You know, people who say have automatic shifting are going to not get as many coins or XP after they finish the race than someone who uses manual, which I think is a very good idea. Even though I don't use, I do use quite a lot of assists. I think it'd be good for those people who don't, because it just gives them a bit of an extra edge over everyone else. A bit of a reward, you know, for taking the leap, taking off some of the assists, but anyway, you can see we're fifth for that huge mistake. We've got a massive train behind us, but I believe we should be able to catch people if we don't make stupid mistakes like that. We got off road, we track extended to the limit, and we've still managed to get past the green car of somebody I don't really know. This is kind of made up of half your friends and then half just random people. But I saw that TMM Marvik Fizzy fan on earlier. It is really fun. I think I'm only friends with them. I don't know if they've been friends with you. You know, you could find anybody from the F1 community or Forza community, whatever community you're from, watching this video, or just, you know, a general YouTube viewer. If you do have an Xbox One, you can see all these people. It's really, really great to see. You know, Forza Horizon 2, I'm not sure how much it'll be. It'll probably be still quite expensive, but, you know, basically, definitely worth picking up. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. I'm just reminding you, it's in full 1080p. I have now got an Xbox One. You guys will be seeing plenty of Forza Horizon 2 gameplay coming in the future. If you do want to see more, be sure to smash that like button and, of course, subscribe so you never miss a video from me. I'm Stracing, and I'll see you guys next time.